the more specific you are, the better. The sort of, you know, narrow down what you're doing. Don't try to explain a whole country or a whole big issue, because you'll just get overwhelmed. This is a lesson I was slow to learn myself, and I tended to throw myself early on into projects where I was going to explain all of Russia or China or whatever, and that way lies madness. You know, and you can't get your head around it. There's not space to write about it. So the more focused you can be, the better off you're going to be. I told a story somewhere yesterday about one of the winners, and this is, you know, your first question about, you know, how young can you be. We're looking for ways that we can incorporate more young journalists in the work that we're doing. And there's a tension, because the Pulitzer Center, our number one mandate is to engage the broadest possible public in these issues. And we want to use journalism to do so, and therefore there's a bias towards, you know, articles, towards projects that can get in the big mass media market. So we want to get on the networks. We want to get in Time and Newsweek and the New York Times. And that tends to push us toward experienced professional journalists. And one thing we've done is that, you know, through the Campus Consortium, where we've gotten colleges to agree to fund collaborations with us, where we bring journalists out here, professional journalists, to talk about their projects. As part of that partnership, we have we set aside money to fund and to mentor a student from each of those colleges each year to go out and do a reporting project. So Stina Eckert, last year, and when Ohio was doing this, that she was part of that. And we have, you know, there are six or eight schools around the country that have that kind of relationship with us. And so if you look on our site, you get a sense of how that works. And we do work closely with those journalists, and we think that's a useful service that we can provide, and it's a way into to the Pulitzer Center. We also did the Project Report, which was this big contest with YouTube, where that was an opportunity that anybody could compete and put together short videos on the video side, but short video projects. We chose the winners. There were five winners this year, and each of the winners got a $10,000 travel fellowship with us, plus, you know, working closely with us to shape the project and guide it through to completion. But long way around. So the story about the Mark Jimaratnam, who was a student at Davidson College, one of the winners for the Project Report. He's in South Africa now, and his proposal initially was to go to South Africa, and he was trying to figure out how he's going to spend the money. He wanted to get Final Cut. He wanted to buy a new camera, so he was already spending three or four grand on equipment. So he had $6,000 left, and he's thinking about how to spend it, and he wanted to go Cape Town, Johannesburg, Durban, sort of travel around the country. And he was interested in youth soccer in the townships and sort of the people who were left out, sort of the aftermath of the World Cup in South Africa, and looking at people who were sort of on the margins. They were soccer players, but poor and few prospects in terms of jobs or career education. And so he initially had this big, unwieldy travel. It was expensive. He was going to a lot of places where he didn't know people. Then we got in conversation, and I said, well, how did you get interested in this? And he said, well, he had a friend who was working for a little NGO that was working with a soccer club in, not in Soweto, but in one of the other townships right outside Johannesburg. And when he was in Johannesburg, he was actually going to stay in the township with these friends from college who were in the township. And I said, well, you know, what you want to do is you want to spend the 6 weeks in that township. Don't go travel. You might, you know, beginning or the end, only for your own, for, you know, for fun, you can go travel around and see the rest of the country. But for the reporting project, just plant yourself in that township and get to know all the players on that team, and you're going to have, that'll be a great story. And I'm confident that it will be a great story. But it's focused. I mean, he has a contact. I was saying before, he's got an NGO. The NGO is going to put him in touch with this community, and he's going to stay long enough that he'll get to know. He'll be able to produce something with authority, and I think that works the best.